you, and let's first address the court hearing issues. Why were you present in court?
Okay. Well, prior to the court hearing held on June 25th, 2015, between Matthew Phillips and Heather DeLock, it was brought to my attention that there was reason to believe evidence may be present that there was pertaining to me as in a video. Although I was not that was not made clear why or how. On the morning of June 25th, my wife also called the clerk's office to explain the circumstances and inquire if my presence at a public hearing would violate the terms of the existing order between me and myself and Mr. Phillips. We were advised by the clerk of the courthouse is under complete surveillance and is considered a safe zone. We were further directed by the clerk that as long as I made an effort not to come in direct contact with Mr. Phillips, attending a public hearing involving Mr. Phillips at the courthouse would not be considered a violation of the existing order. In the motion for contempt filed by Mr. Phillips dated June 30th, 2015, Mr. Phillips makes several statements that are exaggerated and untrue. I would respectfully request the court to review any recordings from that June 25th, 2015 to confirm the following. Mr. Phillips alleges my wife, Jennifer Schmidt, stood up and disrupted the hearing and that she was told to sit down and stay quiet. This is not true. The judge questioned why I may feel it necessary to be at the hearing. When he turned his attention to us, my wife raised her hand, and when the judge looked at her, she stood respectfully to address his inquiry. The judge allowed her to speak. At that time, the judge requested that I remain in the hallway and offered to allow me back in should evidence pertaining to me be presented. I immediately complied with the judge's request. This interaction is a far cry from the over-dramatized version Mr. Phillips included in the contempt paperwork stating I was ordered to leave. I respectfully request the court not schedule this additional contempt hearing based on the above facts and the fact that my motive for attending was not rooted in the attempt to harass anyone. It was merely being aware of any possible evidence pertaining to me personally and was presented. Additionally, I verified the clerk's office that I would like to be that I would be present and follow the direction given by them and the judge in the courtroom. And I actually have the CD from that hearing that states that I was not told that all what was said was I left and never caused any commotion.
Mr. Phillips, do you dispute anything that Mr. Schmidt just said?
The only objection I have is Superior Court has jurisdiction over District Court. So if you talk to District Court, they're probably unaware of the initial orders from Superior, and he was ordered to be away from me at all times. The only thing I want to add to that
but is... But in terms of the advice that Mr. Schmidt may have received from the clerk's office about it being appropriate if he was present in the courtroom, provided he was not disruptive or harassing to you, do you have anything to counter that claim by Mr. Schmidt?
No, I think they were there to harass. There's no reason for any of them to be there.
Yeah, and I guess I was asking you a different question. I was asking whether you have any information that is inconsistent with what Mr. Schmidt said about counsel he may have received from the clerk's office about it being acceptable for him to be present.
No, I don't know anything about that. Right?
That will go to my finding whether or not he's in contempt. Because and I'm not saying I would find this, but even if it was inappropriate advice, if he relied on advice from an official of the clerk's office about it being okay for him to be here, that's something that I may factor into whether or not a finding of contempt is appropriate, if you understand.
Yeah, well, I just want to reiterate the hearing. It was just a scheduled conference review for the hearing that's coming to in November, and it's about the kids. There's nothing in that hearing that has anything to do with him or Stop Free Keene, and they all know that. There's nothing that's going to be presented that has anything to do with it. It's parenting time. It's not a custody battle. It's half and half custody that's already in order. Nobody's losing custody. It's parenting time that's on the table. And there's nothing to do with them for the hearing. And if you if you hear the CD, if he's allowed to present it, the judge was boggled by the presence. He was very.
Your point is that this is a routine hearing. There really was no purpose to be served by his presence at the hearing. So under those circumstances, you consider his very presence to be in violation of the order and an act of harassment.
Yes, sir.
Anything further that you'd like to say on that, Mr. Schmidt?
I'd just like to mention that the video of that was presented to you in the last case that I wasn't able to make is on that date that I did come to, of the day that we had our confrontation. Heather, the wife, is using some of the video because of that day. He was allegedly supposed to be taking care of his kids instead of being at 75 Levy Street. That's the reason why I wanted to be there, because my face is on the video and it pertains to me.
So you're saying your purpose to be there was because you thought there's may have been something raised about the events that were captured on the video.
Yes.
And if your name was going to be discussed, you wanted to be present in court to hear what was said about you.
Correct.
Anything further on that?
I just want to object. He's given testimony to someone that's not present and unaccounted for, Your Honor.
So your objection is it's hearsay?
Yes.
I will, so before me now, that I'll take under advisement are two things. One, Mr. Schmidt's motion to reconsider the earlier decision, and two, the motion for contempt that you filed, the recent motion that you filed, Mr. Phillips, for contempt. Is there anything more that you wanted to say or present on the recently filed motion for contempt?
No, Your Honor, unless the court is satisfied with what they heard.
Yeah, I'm not going to give you sort of a read on what I'm going to decide.
I was going to go into if the court wanted to hear the witness of his further actions around 775 Leverett Street, or it can be satisfied with what was told in court today.
Well, as I understand it, the motion for contempt that was filed really revolves around actions that were taken in the court at this family law matter that you had in your request that Mr. Schmidt be found in contempt based on his very presence in at that proceeding. Now you're raising kind of a new issue, and if you want to file that as a separate grounds for contempt, due process requires that Mr. Schmidt have notice of that additional claim. So I understand. I'm going to take that evidence really as evidence about his motivation at the earlier hearing, but not as a separate ground for contempt in this case. If you want to raise that as another argument for contempt, I just ask that you file that as a separate claim for contempt so that Mr. Schmidt has an opportunity to see the claim and respond to it. He doesn't have to do it on the fly in the middle of a court hearing.
Yeah, I understand. The only thing that I want to add is I actually did see him on the bike that day in very close proximity, and I didn't file a motion of contempt. I noticed that he was doing something on his own. He looked at me and did go away. So I just want to show the court that I'm not out to get him in any way. I just feel that was just inappropriate in violation of the order.
Let me say I'm going to take both these matters under advisement. Just until I've issued a decision and going forward, the best thing that the two of you can do is try to avoid as much as possible any contact with each other. My guess is given how things have gone, any presence nearby raises the specter of either one of you filing a further motion for contempt or a further request for sanction, and I think Keene is a big enough community that you can take steps to try to avoid each other. If there are times when inadvertently there's some contact, if you could try to walk the other way rather than engaging, that would be a beneficial thing to do. But I will take both the motion for reconsideration and the motion for contempt under advisement. Thank you both very much. If I can see the council in the